Control stem. First, we will see the control stem syllabus for electrical, electronics, and instrumentation students. Total control system syllabus I am dividing into 8 parts, means 8 units. The topic number 1 is introduction to control system. In this, we have to discuss what is meant by system, what is meant by control system, then in types of control system, next, transfer function, finally, effects of feedback. All these things will clear about basics of the subject. And second topic comes under signal flow graph and block diagram reduction techniques. Third topic, stability. In this, we need to discuss Bibos table. Bibos stands bounded input, bounded output stability. Bibos table, next, marginal stability, conditional stability, absolute stability, relative stability, asymptotic stability, finally, Routh-Hurwitz stability criteria. He is a scientist based on respect. We are calling Routh-Hurwitz, or simply first letters of this name, RH criteria, or simply RH stability criteria. These are the first three topics. First one, introduction to control system. Second one, signal flow graph. Third one, stability. Next, fourth topic, time response analysis. In this, we need to discuss transient and steady state behavior of first and second order systems, next, time domain specifications, error coefficients, PI, PD, PID controllers. PI, PD, PID controllers. This is the fourth topic. Next, fifth topic, root locus. In this, we have 11 number of rules, how to construct the root locus and how to determine stability from that. Next, topic number 6, frequency response analysis. Topic number 6, frequency response analysis. We need to discuss in this frequency domain specifications, Bode plot, polar plot, Nyquist plot, lead and lag, compensators or controllers. This is the sixth topic. Seventh topic, mathematical modeling of control system. Mathematical modeling of control system. Last topic, state space analysis. See, in this we need to discuss what is meant by state, then state vector, state variable, state transition matrix, solution to state equation, finally controllability and observability. This is the syllabus of control system for electrical students and electronic students, then instrumentation students. The instrumentation students having only 50% of this depth, but I am suggesting you instrumentation engineers, please try to listen entire my class. It will be helpful to you during interview level as well as subject standard level. So I am thinking all three people will have common syllabus with respect to interview as well as IAS and gate level. Now we have seen the syllabus. Second thing, how to prepare control system for competitive exams like gate, IAS and IAS. My class will be covering three examinations. One is gate, second is IAS standard, third is IAS standard. Also it is helpful to interviews for public, various public sectors and IAS level, IAS level, anywhere you can utilize this concept for interview level also, right? Now the test books for preparing control system is, first book, Control Systems by B.C. Cuyo. Benjamin C. Cuyo is a good author. Theory is very good. Problem standard also very good in depth level. Next. Second book, same author. Control Systems by Nees. Control Systems by Ogata. Control Systems by M. Gopal, he is IIT Delhi professor, good standard. Next, Control Systems by Nagrathan Gopal. There are many more test books are there, but these five books I am preferring for preparing theory as well as problem standards. Next, for solving problems, this for theory as well as problems, for practicing more number of problems, our material. Second, Control Systems by Anand Kumar is a local standard book, but problems are very good. As many problems you can find in this textbook, you can practice more and more. Third one, Control Systems by Sham series. In this series, all subject questions are depth and various levels. As many as questions you are practicing, that much will become perfect in this test book. These are the three books and these are the five books for theory as well as problems. Finally, all these things is not required. Please listen carefully my class, our classroom, lectures, plus I am solving so many problems with many more shortcuts. Definitely it will be helpful to you. You can't find all these things in any textbook. It is only based on my experience. Sit back, relax, we will enjoy the control system, right? But I given reference if you required any time textbooks. But for gate level IAS and IAS standard, no need to study all these things, only our classroom lectures and then shortcuts. It is enough to practice all these books. Now how to prepare, I explained. First we have discussed the syllabus, then how to prepare, I explained. Third one, how many marks we can expect in gate level from this control system book, from control system subject. The number of marks, I can't conclude this many exactly, because right now exam is online exam, not offline. In online exam, we have different set of question paper. In first set, that means set 1, someone may get, or I am writing 8 exam, in set 1, I can get 8 marks from control system. Whereas set 2 question paper, the questions will not repeat from same. Other questions are asking from the same control system subject, they can ask for 10 marks. That is the reason why I am unable to tell exactly how many number of questions or how many number of marks we can expect from control system. Not only from control system, any subject right now we can't say exactly how many marks they are asking, right, from the control system, because we have different set of question papers. We can't say exactly these many questions and these many marks from control system. That's the reason why I am not telling the number of marks. Finally, I am entering into the discussion of subject. I know control system subject. Already you also know control system subject. So we both are discussing at a great level. Therefore, we will enjoy the subject. Relax, sit back right now. Now, the first topic in control system is introduction to control system. Introduction to control system. In this, we have to discuss what is mean by system. In this, we have to discuss what is mean by system. See, fan is one system, tube light is one system, washing machine is one system, classroom is one system, traffic lights is one system. There are so many examples we have practically systems. Let's take fan. Input to the fan is electrical energy. Input to the fan is electrical energy, and it is going to be converted into mechanical energy, that is airflow. Fan is giving output as airflow, that is mechanical energy. Tube light is a system, input is also electrical energy, output is light energy. Washing machine is also one system, input is electrical energy, output is some mechanical work done, which is also comes under mechanical energy. Like classroom is also one system, input is teaching, output is number of gate ranks. Output is number of gate ranks. Number of gate ranks from load side. Load side means student side, right? If you take like this n number of examples, in all these examples, in middle we have system. Before system, there is a input. These are all called inputs. And these are all called outputs. These are all called outputs. In middle, we have system. Therefore, I am developing general block diagram for all these diagrams. The general block diagram for all this diagram is, first one is input to the system, then output is present after the system. So these are all called inputs. In middle we have system, then we have output. Output of the system may be desired or may be undesired. Output of the system is may be desired or may be undesired. Now we are going to discuss what is the basic definition of system. What is system is combination of components, combination of physical components, we can say like this, combination of physical components are connected together to perform certain task is called a system. Once again, combination of different physical components are connected together to perform certain task is called system. Practically, there are so many examples for system also. One is electrical system is also one big system. In this, physical components are resistor, inductor and capacitor. In this, physical components are resistor, inductor and capacitor. Electrical system is one example. Second, mechanical system. Third, hydraulic system. Fourth, education system, educational system. Fifth, political system. Sixth, domestic system. Like, there are so many examples for system. What are the examples for system? Electrical system, mechanical system, hydraulic system, educational system, political system and domestic system, right? Now the block diagram of system is, it is having input and it is processing output. The output may be desired or undesired. Now I will give some more explanation for this system. Even though these are all basics, we want to learn in depth so that next syllabus, that means coming topics, will be very easy for us for understanding purpose for you and me, right? Right now, let's come to the fan. Fan is having so many equipments. Initially, if you see in your home, there is a switchboard. From the switchboard, there is a wire. Wire is nothing but conductor. Conductor is connected to a coil. Coil is having three blades. A coil is having three blades like this. And a conductor is connected to the coil from the switchboard. All these components are physically, all these physical components, these are all physical components. All these physical components are connected together to perform certain task is called system. In this system, we have input as well as output. The output may be desired or undesired. Why I am saying it is desired or undesired is, if we take the example of fan, if there is no regulator, some of the fans in our home will have no regulators. Some of the fans are having regulators. Regulators are nothing but speed controllers. Whereas without regulator means, is a simply system without controller. Regulator is nothing but controller. Assumption, in our home there is no regulator. If the speed of the fan is very high, and that too that is winter season. During winter season, speed is running at a high speed. Fan is running at a high speed. Automatically will start shivering. Definitely, which is undesired output. Whereas the same fan without regulator during winter season, outside temperature is very high. At the time, definitely we expect high speed. At the time, speed of the fan is desired, right? That means, without regulator, speed of the fan or output of the system may be desired or undesired. This is about system. What is mean by system? Finally, we are concluding. Combination of different physical components are connected together to perform certain task is called system. What are the examples? Electrical system, mechanical system, hydraulic system, educational system, political system, domestic system. All this comes under system example. Mainly we are going to be electrical engineers. We are under the family of electrical engineers. Whereas EC, EE, EA, all are the family of electrical engineers. All are the branches of tree. That is electrical tree. In our electrical tree, what are the physical components means? Resistor, inductor and capacitor. And some more examples of the system is fan, tube light, washing machine, classroom, traffic lights. All these are the examples of system. In all these examples, we have certain input and producing output. That output may be desired or undesired because there is no regulator in the system. Right? I can say finally, any system is having certain input, produces output. Output may be desired or undesired. The examples are fan, tube light, washing machine, classroom, traffic lights, etc., etc. Let's take classroom. Teacher is presence, students are presence, benches, whiteboard, marker, duster, AC, fan, lights, all these components are working together to perform certain task is called as system, right? And one more thing, if you observe here, if you take any system, input is one form of energy and output is another form of energy. According to law of conservation of energy, energy can't be created or can't be destroyed. It can be converted one form to another form with the help of systems, with the help of systems. This is about system. Next, control system. So, in system, output may be desired or undesired. Next one is control system. Now we will understand what is the basic difference between system and control system. This is the example of system. Now we will go into discuss about control system. Let's take fan. Fan is there. Input to the fan is electrical energy. After immediately electrical energy, there is a regulator called controller. Regulator. You have seen regulator like a circular position in our home, near to the switches. There are 5 positions generally, 4 or 5. At 0 position, resistance is very high. Current flow is 0. And as the position is increasing from 1 to 5, at 5th position, resistance is very less. Current flow is very high. Right? After regulator, there is a fan. Fan is nothing but conductor, coil, all three blades are connected together. Then fan is giving output as mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. Now, due to regulator, we can change the position of the knob of the regulator. Whenever you are changing the position of the knob of the regulator, automatically we will get the desired output according to our design manner, that is mechanical energy, right? Therefore, in this case, output is desired or undesired? Desired. Now, I require general block diagram. This is the block diagram of fan, but you have to develop a general block diagram for all the examples. For that, electrical energy can be treated as input. Regulator is treated as controller. Whereas fan is treated as system, mechanical energy is treated as output. Mechanical energy is treated as output. In this case, output is desired. Now I am erasing this block diagram because we have general block diagram right now. Let's take. Now you observe here, what is the basic difference between system and control system is, in system, control action is absence, by that output may be desired or undesired. In control system, due to control action, definitely output is desired output, right? Now we have to understand what is meant by control action. Control action means direct the system or regulate the system or command the system. What is meant by control action means either direct the system or regulate the system or command the system. What is meant by direct? Recently one of the Telugu movie became a biggest hit, that is Bahubali 2. You know this. In Bahubali 2, the hero is Prabhas, villain is Rana, heroines Anushka and Tamanna, Kattappa and Shivagami, all these great actors, so many great actors are acted in that Bahubali 2 movie under the direction of Rajamouli. Rajamouli has directed them such that the output of the system is mostly desired output. Similar, that means Rajamouli is directing them to get the desired output. Means indirectly, Rajamouli is having some control action over all the actors, by that output is desired output. Similarly, I am going to teach control system all of you. It's a friendly discussion. Not I am teacher, you are students. I am going to discuss control system to all of you. That means indirectly I am directing you all students to get the best marks in control system. That is, I'm promising full marks. 100% guarantee warranty, you will get full marks in control system after listening my class. That means I am also controlling you, indirectly controlling by the way of directing how to answer the control system questions in interviews and exam difficult competitive exam levels, right? Therefore, it is also one type of control action. Next, regulate the system. Just now I have explained, by changing the position of the knob of the regulator in your home, the speed of the fan will be controlled. It is also one type of control action. Next, command the system. Command the system. We have different examples to discuss command the system. If we have full command and control system subject, definitely we will get full marks in gate exam, IAS exam, IAS exam. Also, you can easily, by confident, you will overcome the interviews so that you will become control action over the control system subject. That is, commanding the subject. Or else, LKG students are there in a school. The small students are doing big noise rather than studying. Automatically, teacher is commanding their small students. Otherwise, they will not get be controlled. That means, output is not desired. Similarly, instead of coming to control system class, you are going to watch the Bahubali 2 movie. If father knows that you are not attending control system class and your education route is diverting, automatically they will command you. By that, your output is desired output. That means commanding is also one type of control action. Directing is also one type of control action. Regulating is also one type of control action. By this all actions, automatically system output is desired output. System output is desired output. Now, the main difference between system and control system is, here control action is absence, there control action is presence. Second one, because of absence of control action, output may be desired or undesired. Because of control action, output is desired output. Because of control action, output is desired output. This is the main difference between system and control system. Now, how many type of control actions are there? This is the biggest question right now. Previously, we understand what is mean by system. Then we have understand what is mean by control system. Now, the control actions are only one type or different types we have to understand right now. Basically, the control action is of two types. One is manual control action. That means manually some work. By man, we are doing something. And second one is automatic control action, right? Now, types of control action systems. Types of control systems. Types of control systems. There are two types of control systems. One is manual control system, second one, automatic control system. Manual control system is also called open loop control system, or else another name, non-feedback control system. What is another name? Non-feedback control system. Automatic control system, another name is called closed loop control system, or else feedback control system. How many types of control system? Two types. One is manual control system, or else open loop, or else non-feedback control system. CS means control system. Second one, automatic, another name called closed loop, another name called feedback control system. How these names are called came, we will discuss right now. First one, manual control system, or open loop control system, or non-feedback control system. Let's take open loop system block diagram. Just now we have discussed, initially we have input, after input there is a control action, that is regulator. Regulator in general can be written as controller. After controller there is a system. Fan is nothing but system. After system, we have output. That output is desired output. Now, will discuss one by one points about this open loop system. Once we are discussing about open loop system and closed loop system, we don't have much theory, we have only problems with respect to concepts. We'll solve all the problems by very simple shortcut manners, right? Control system entire class is shortcut, right? Just try to understand by this theory, open loop and closed loop. After that, we'll go by problem section only. Let us concentrate. First one. First point in open loop control system. There is no connection from output to input. In open loop control system, there is a connection from input to output, which is nothing but forward path. By the name itself, we'll understand it is a path. Path means way. From forward direction means input to output is called forward direction. And there is no feedback path. Feedback means from output to input. There is no connection from output to input. Hence, it is without feedback or non-feedback control system. As there is no feedback, it is not making. If there is a feedback, it will become a loop. If there is a feedback, it will become a loop. As there is no feedback, it is nothing but open loop. It is nothing but open loop. That is the reason why manual control system is also called open loop or non-feedback system. What is the first point? In open loop control system, OLCS means open loop control system, there is no connection. There is no connection from output to input. Or there is no feedback path from output to input. First point, I think it is very clear. Second point. Control action is independent on output. Control action is independent on output because there is no sensor. Sensor nothing but feedback. Because there is no sensor to sense and control the output. Why it is independent? Control action is independent output because there is no sensor or there is no feedback to sense and control the output. Therefore, it is controlled manually but not automatically. Let's take fan. You will understand by example of fan. Now, fan is running. Running means output. It is producing mechanical energy, that is airflow as output. I am getting shivering. Shivering means that speed is very high. Outside temperature is very low. Whenever I am started shivering, definitely I have to reduce the speed of the fan. How to reduce the speed of the fan? By looking the towards the fan, the speed of the fan will not be controlled. In some of the Telugu movies, some of the heroes, by looking like this, the fan will be controlled, train is going back. And so many abnormal things are happening. That is just movie, but not reality. In real life, if fan is running at high speed when I am shivering, definitely by looking towards the fan, it will not control because the fan is not having sensor to sense and adjust according to my body. That is the reason why control action is independent output. Then how to reduce the speed of the fan? By going towards the switchboard, I am manually moving towards the switchboard. And I am changing the regulator position, automatically it will be controlled because there is no sensor in the fan. If sensor is present inside of the fan, automatically it will change the speed by its own. That is nothing but automatic. Sensor is nothing but feedback. Feedback, sensor, all are common names. There is no difference in meanings, right? Now, control action is independent on output because there is no sensor to sense and control the output and is controlled manually. What is the example? Fan. Examples are fan, ordinary washing machine, bread toaster. Automatic tea or coffee maker. Fifth one, light switch. Fifth one, light switch. Sixth one, traffic control. Traffic control. These are all the examples of open loop system. Let us take ordinary, okay, one more example, electric hand dryer. Electric hand dryer. Now only we have discussed about fan. Now we will discuss about ordinary washing machine. In your home, washing machine is there. Inside of washing machine, you are keeping the some clothes. It is this washing machine running. This washing machine is running according to preset time, irrespective of whether cloth is washed or not. Even washing is completed or not completed, we have to set the time for 1 hour or 2 hour if there is no sensor. Nowadays in washing machine also sensor is there. I am speaking about ordinary washing machine which is comes under without sensor. If a washing machine is not having any sensor, if you are placing the cloth inside of the washing machine, it will run according to preset time even though the washing is completed or not. Right? Therefore, it comes under open loop system, means there is no sensor. Next, bread toaster. It is also working according to as per adjusted time even though bread is toasted or not. Even though the bread is toasted or not, if you are going bakery shop, just to ask, give me some burger or pizza, the shopkeeper is putting the burger or pizza inside of the microwave or bread toaster, and he will set the time. According to setting time, it will bake even though it is toasted or not. It is also open loop system. Next, light switch. See, the lamp in our home, we have tube light or lamp. The lamp glows whenever the light switch is on, irrespective of light is required or not. Example, now when the sun is sets after 7 pm completely outside is darkness, at that time light is required. If you switch on the light switch, automatically the lamp glows. If there is a sun shining before sunset, there is a light outside. In our home also, due to windows, there is a light, right? At that time also, if you switch on the tube light, definitely the lamp glows. That means, whenever you are switch on the switch, the lamp is automatically started glowing. But the lamp is not understanding whether it is required or not. During daytime it is on, during nighttime it is on. It is giving light during daytime and nighttime, irrespective of the sunshine and sunset. It is also without sensor, that's why it comes under open loop system. Next, electric hand dryer. If you see electric hand dryer in airports, generally if you see in airports, if you go into bathrooms after washing your face and hands, generally people are coming outside, there is a electric hand dryer. If you are putting your hand under the electric hand dryer, as long as you keep the hand under the electric hand dryer, it is releasing hot air. Hot air is nothing but output. Whenever it is releasing hot air, as long as you keep your hand under the electric hand dryer, it is releasing the hot air. That means the electric hand dryer is not understanding whether your hand is having wet or dry. Even though it is dry, if you keep under that, definitely it is releasing hot air. Even it is wet, it is releasing hot air. That means it is not having sensor. If it is having sensor, whenever your hand is wet position, then only it will release hot air. But if it is not having sensor, even your hand is like dry position, it will release hot air. That is open loop system, means there is no sensor. Next, traffic control in India, I will discuss this. Automatic tea or coffee maker, it is also working according to preset time, right? All these examples comes under open loop system. Now we will discuss about traffic control. Let's take any one signal or any one junction in any one of metropolitan city, either Hyderabad or Delhi or Chennai, Bengaluru, Pune, Mumbai, Kolkata, Patna, any one metropolitan city, let's take one signal, right? In our India, there is no sensor at the junction. Only police person is standing. One police, traffic police is standing. He is controlling the traffic. Police is controlling traffic means definitely it comes under manual control, but not automatic control. If sensor is there at the junction, then it is automatically comes under automatic control action or closed loop control system. Because of manual action, it comes under open loop system, traffic control in India. See, this side number of vehicles are less, assumption. Under assumptions, I am discussing some points here. Under assumptions, I am assuming this side number of vehicles are less. I am assuming number of vehicles are more in this side. But allotted time or preset time of each and every side of the signal is 60 seconds, means equivalent to 1 minute. The preset time of all the sides of the signal is 60 seconds. When our vehicles are more here, within 60 seconds unable to cross all the vehicles, assumption 50% of vehicles within 60 seconds are crossing the signal. Remaining 50% of vehicles is waiting for one more signal that will take 60 seconds plus 60 seconds plus 60 seconds after 180 seconds, means after 3 minutes the signal is present here. Whenever the signal is on this side, within 180 seconds number of vehicles still adding, once again the vehicles are more. Whenever the vehicles are more on this side, definitely traffic is becoming more big issue on this side. People are frustrated to cross the signal, right? They are taking more time to cross the signal. Let's come to this side. Whenever vehicles are less comparatively that side, assumption within 30 seconds all vehicles are crossing the junction, but preset time of all the sides is equal, that is 60 seconds. Whenever within 30 seconds all vehicles are cross the junction, remaining 30 seconds is waste of time. Why it is waste of time? Even though there is no vehicle, still 30 seconds time is present, but vehicle is not there. Therefore, here we are allotting more time, but here even though vehicles are more, we are allotting less time. Here traffic is become a big issue, here there is no traffic, right? See, what we have to understand here is, if police is there, he will analyze manually and he will give the time. If police uncle is not standing throughout the day, this problem will arise. Therefore, this system is not accurate system, means less accurate system. This system is less accurate system. But as there is no sensor, this system is very simple to design. Open loop system is very simple to design. And maintenance also very easy. As there is no sensor, maintenance is not required. Therefore, easy to maintain. Third one, as sensor is not present, no doubt it is very low cost. Cost is very less, that is cost is cheap. These are all advantages, but this is the disadvantage, that is less accurate system. Why? Because sometimes vehicles are more in one side, vehicles are less in another side, but we are allotting same time for both the sides. At the time, one side will become big, more traffic issue, another side will become, that means time is wasting, right? That is the reason why less accurate system. And one more thing, in open loop system, just now I have drawn block diagram. First we have initial input, then immediately we have controller, after controller we have system, after system we have output. Any changes in output in open loop system, any changes in output will not be corrected immediately because there is no sensor. Any changes in output or any non-linearities in output will not be suddenly corrected because there is no feedback, right? That means it is having more non-linearities. One side it is having advantage, that is simple to design, easy to maintain, low cost. Another side accuracy is less, it is having more non-linearities or more disturbances or more oscillations, right? All are same meanings. Next, open loop systems are more stable or closed loop systems are more stable? This is a big question. In DRDO interview also I face this question. What is the answer for this question is, open loop control systems are more stable. Open loop control systems are more stable comparatively closed loop control system, provided that system will not have any disturbances. Under this condition, this is valid definition, otherwise it is invalid. What is valid thing is, open loop control systems are more stable. Open loop control systems are more stable compared to closed loop control system, provided that system will not have any disturbances. Provided that system will not have any disturbances. Now I will explain the statement. Let us concentrate. This is control system classroom just beside the highway. This is the highway. Just beside the highway, this is the building. In this building, control system class is going on. All students are came. I am taking one of the best couple, hot couple, hot news in the India. One is Virat Kohli, just for assumption, not for insulting them. Another one, Anushka Sharma. One is Virat Kohli, other is Anushka Sharma. Assumption, on this particular day, now control system class is going on, this day completely road is blocked due to some reasons. No vehicle is coming, no vehicle is going, road is full of empty, that means without any disturbance road is presence. Assumption, Virat Kohli is a blind person. Assumption only, please don't mind. Assumption, Virat Kohli is a blind person. Blind person means he can't see anything, means sensor is not present. Eyes are sensor. If eyes is not there, he can't observe anything and he can't see anything and he can't apply feedback immediately. Therefore, Virat Kohli is a blind person. Blind person means open loop control system, whereas Anushka Sharma is a closed loop system. Eyes is present, definitely closed loop system. Under without any disturbance, assumption both are walking by same velocity towards the control system classroom. As there is no disturbance, Virat Kohli will not observe anything in this road. Immediately, without any time delay, he will reach the control system class and he is listening class perfectly. Therefore, his stability is more. When it comes to Anushka Sharma, as she is a normal person, she can see what is presence of the sights. If any car is parked, she will check how much she is beautiful by looking the car glasses of some time. Like this, some of the time is wasted, that means some of the disturbance, even though the road is under without disturbance, because of eyes, she is not applying proper feedback, she is sensing in different directions, that's why she is delayed to the classroom. That's why she is delayed to the classroom. That means without any disturbances, without, under this condition, conditions are powerful in engineering subjects, in professional subjects. Conditions are powerful. Without conditions, if you are developing any statement, that will definitely kill the subject. Now I am saying once again, the condition is without any disturbance, without any disturbance, open loop control system is more stable when compared to closed loop control system, by example of Virat Kohli and Anushka Sharma, right? This is the example of stability discussion, right? This is about open loop system. Next, closed loop system. Just now we have seen open loop system. Now we will discuss the closed loop system behavior, right? Closed loop system block diagram also same as open loop, but sensor is present in closed loop system. Input is present initially, then controller. After input there is a controller. After controller there is a system. After system there is a output. From output to input there is a connection which is called sensor or nothing but feedback. Now feedback signal and input signal must together has to connect. For that we required one application called summing point. This is the symbol of summing point. What is the purpose of summing point? Is to connect more than one signal. To connect more than one signal we required summing point. This is summing point. Now input is always positive signal. Input is always positive signal, whereas sensor is connecting from output input, that is feedback is connecting from output input. This sensor will be two ways. One is positive feedback or positive sensor or negative sensor. Generally we have negative feedback control system. Practically 99% of control system subjects are negative feedback control. Only 1% is positive feedback. To utilize the positive feedback control system we required high skilled engineers. But practically in our subject, that means with respect to BTech standard and MTech standard, 99% of control system we are using negative feedback but not positive feedback. We'll discuss further as topics are moving towards the end. We'll discuss about what is the difference between positive feedback and negative feedback. We'll take break, we'll continue.